So, thank you for the nice introduction and welcome everyone also from my side. In the following 20 minutes, I want to work out the synergy between the OSLC concept of global configurations and feature-based product line engineering. To make this more graspable, we will have a look at the toolchain consisting of the IBM Engineering Lifecycle Management platform that implements global configurations and the PLE tool Pure Variance that comes with a connector for the IBM ELM platform. Before we get into the actual topic, I want to briefly introduce you to the company Pure Systems that I'm working for, disclaimer, and that develops and distributes Pure Variance. Next, I will give you a brief explanation of product line engineering in general. Prepared with that knowledge, we will have a look at the synergies between global configurations and the OSLC concept, and as an OSLC concept and the product line engineering as a standard for systematic reuse of engineering assets, and work out the advantages for companies that are developing product families of complex systems. After a brief summary, we have some time reserved for your questions. So Pure Systems is on the market since 2001. We are headquartered in Magdeburg, Germany, and are operating worldwide, fully focused on the topic of systematic reuse of engineering assets according to the product line engineering approach. Our customers mainly stem from industries that are developing complex systems consisting of hardware and software like automotive, aerospace, defense, and rails, and transportation. As an Encosim member, we are well connected into the systems engineering world and contributed to the ISO 26580 standard about feature-based product line engineering. We are also involved in various research projects together with partners from industries, universities, and research institutes, and keep using joint research projects as a format to develop new ideas that find their way into our product Pure Variance.
Hey, Robert, are you presenting a chart? Because at least on my system, I only see you inside the tile.
Oh, I'm sorry. Yes, thank you for making me aware of this.
Yeah, I don't know what you're saying. So I was sure it's on my system.
So now you should also see my screen, right?
Yes.
Yeah, now we see it, yeah.
Perfect. So our offering consists of the variant management tool Pure Variance that comes with integrations to various engineering tools to implement holistic variant management across the engineering lifecycle and across tool borders. This is accompanied by services under the brand Pure Consult. So under this brand, we provide our customers with professional support that covers all phases from an early guided evaluation to the productive use of Pure Variance. So what does systematic reuse according to the feature-based product line engineering approach actually mean? Let me give a brief introduction. In PLE, we rely on two major concepts to achieve the systematic reuse of engineering assets. On one hand, we rely on feature modeling to capture an abstract engineering asset independent level or on an independent level, the difference that variants of our product lines can have among each other. Each such difference is modeled as a feature and set into relations with other features of a product line. For example, a feature could be a functionality that is part of some but not all variants. A market for which we want to develop some variants can be a feature as well, as depending on the decision to provide variants for a specific market, those variants may require functionalities that are mandatory for this market, but optional or non-available for other markets. Such interdependency information is formalized and put into the feature model. And this feature model is then connected to so-called 150% engineering assets to express that the variable parts of those assets are only needed for variants wherein certain features are relevant. So an example for such engineering assets can be requirements, code, architecture models, test cases, and so on. Which features are relevant for a specific variant is configured in a so-called variant description model. This model contains all features we defined earlier in the feature model, but in the VDM, we select the subset of those features of the feature model that shall be part of this specific variant. So you have the feature model once for your whole product line, and then one variant description model per variant where you actually tell which part of the feature model is relevant. So Our variant management tool is also helping you in this step by taking into account all the interdependencies that you have modeled into the feature model and guides you through the variant configuration process by showing you places where you have to make additional decisions, telling you which other features based on your current decisions cannot be selected as well, and so on. So to ensure that you end up in a valid configuration according to the expert knowledge you put it into the feature models. Based on such a VDM, the variant-specific assets can now be generated out of the 150% engineering assets in a so-called transformation, as we have earlier linked features to variable parts of the solution assets. This has multiple advantages, like consistency across asset types. If you consider that the same feature model is linked to different asset types, we config your variant once by feature selection and then generate variant specific assets in those different tools consistently all according to the same feature selection. So now that we had a brief introduction to PLE, to the concept of PLE, let's come to the actual topic of today, global configurations in product line engineering. We, as well as our customers, see a huge synergy between the use of global configurations for engineering data management and product line engineering for the systematic reuse of engineering data across product variants. And I want to give some insight into why, with the goal of making you aware of this strong synergy between those two concepts. So, on its own, global configurations provide great value by giving engineers an entity under which they can baseline across engineering assets of different type that reside in different version control systems and in different tools. At the same time, global configurations provide a context in which links between engineering assets can be established and live. They provide the capability of creating a branch on global configuration level, which implies the creation of branches for each of the local streams that are part of a global configurations, which can come from different tools and contain assets of different types. Product line engineering is interacting with global configurations in two ways. On the one hand, PLE assets like feature models and variant description models can become part of a global configuration. A pure variance model server, for example, that manages these models implements the stream provider interface to make it possible to include those models into a global configuration. This means in the case you are using pure variance, product line engineering is out of the box integrated into global configurations, and feature models and variant models can become part of a global configuration baseline to express that these models are consistent with the 150% engineering assets and variant-specific assets can be generated out of these. On the other hand, if you are using pure variants, global configurations are integrated into PLE. Instead of just generating a 100% requirement document from a 150% requirements document, pure variants can take a whole global configuration with multiple streams with 150% engineering assets inside, as we see here, as an input, and generate variant-specific global configuration streams out of it that hold generated variant-specific output for all of these asset types. While maintaining the links that have been established on the 150% level also in the variant-specific global configuration branch. As from the global configuration perspective, those are the same assets in a separate branch. You can even continue to work on this 100% on variant specific output with the option at hand to regenerate the same variant based on a newer baseline of the 150% assets to receive updates from the 150% to the 100% without losing local changes. So this gives you flexibility in engineering and allows you to decide which problems you solve initially for on product line level to make the solution available for all variants that need it, and which ones you first prefer to serve in a variant specific context and later on get back into the product line with the capability to receive updates all the times. So So let's have an intermediate overview of capabilities when combining those approaches. On one hand, you get the approach to baselining across reusable assets, thanks to global configurations. You have a centralized configuration of variants based on feature models, so based on independency knowledge that your experts put into this model, thanks to PLE. You get automated calculation and instantiation of variant-specific engineering assets based on a centralized configuration, thanks to PLE. And this will also keep traces between engineering assets intact, thanks to global configurations. Flexibility to continue development in variant-specific engineering assets is another advantage, as I just mentioned. So that happens thanks to the combination of PLE and global configurations and stream concepts in the background, so the interaction of PLE and configuration management. So to give you, to make this more graspable, I want to give a demonstration of configuring a variant based on a feature model in pure variance and the generation of a variant-specific global configuration out of a 150% global configuration, as well as running an update of an already existing variant that has been changed manually. In this example, while pure variance provides the capabilities needed to control variability in engineering assets based on feature selections, we will in addition use the IBM ELM platform and DOS Next to demonstrate the global configuration part. So let's start on pure variance side.
I know I should have asked you before your presentation. There is a VEL. Given that you talked about the bridge between the variability and global configurations, I know that Pure Systems is active in OASIS, promoting efforts on variability exchange language.
Yes.
I was hoping you could talk about that during your presentation as well, how OSLC and VEL communities could collaborate.
Yes, sure. Yeah. So I didn't want to come with the same topics as last year, but of course, yeah. So we are pushing VEL as a standard there for exchange of variability information between variant management tools and engineering tools. And we are actually already using VEL for our integrations. So what we will see today in the background also uses some of this VEL to be standard as a data format standard to get basically on the one hand side the information which IDs of engineering data exist somewhere in a tool that has a mapping rule on it that connects it to the feature model, to the variant management tool. And on the other hand, the variant management tool uses VEL to give the information back that for a specific variant, this rule evaluate to false or true for a specific variant, so that the engineering tool on the other hand knows whatever is connected to that rule is part of a variant-specific generated output or not. So basically, that's what we are using in the background here when we go to configure a variant based on an existing feature model in a variant model. And I will go a little bit faster forward here. We configure a variant via feature selection. So we here actually see the features of an existing feature model wherein we modeled which features exist in a product line, how are they related to each other. And you see the tool already initially points us at places where we have to make decisions to end up in a valid variant according to that knowledge. So we can navigate to these places by clicking on these arrow markers and make a decision to, in this example where we have a product line for front car light systems in front of us, whether we want to include xenon or halogen light to a specific variant. And you will see there are also relations going across the model. For example, if we select a market now, let's say Sweden as a market, you will see that a certain more functional features like hazard warning will be auto-selected as we modeled a relation that this other feature is needed in the case this market is chosen for the specific variant. On the IBM ELM side, when we look at our requirements in DOS Next, we have here a look at a superset of requirements. With the help of an Intel integration, we can load our just configured variant, so our feature selections for variant, into the integration view on DOS Next side, and we can have a preview of how the variant-specific output for this variant would actually look like on requirement side. So we see that some of the requirements are not needed, and this is decided based on these rules that are put onto the different requirements to map them to features, which is not always a one-to-one relation, but can be N-to-M, and it's basically a logical expression. At the same time, these requirements can also be linked via OSLC links to features, as PureVariance is also an OSLC provider. So as there is currently no specific standard to connect to a variant management tool, PureVariance exposes itself as a requirements management tool, and you can create OSLC links to features and to whole variants on PureVariance side accordingly. So now if we know what we saw in the preview we like to instantiate, then we can make use of this interaction between the PLE tool and the global configurations and actually generate out of a superset global configuration that we have here that is mapped to features, or which content is mapped to features, a variant-specific global configuration that then only contains the subset of engineering assets that is needed according to this feature selection. So this can be triggered in the background in headless mode. Here we trigger this manually. So while this global configuration transformation is running, we are basically branching out of a baseline of the 150% global configuration. Sorry. And inside that, we remove those parts of the engineering assets that are not needed. Coming back to the ELM platform, we can switch to the newly generated global configuration for that variant. And we will see why we stay in the same modules. And we will see that in that global configuration, the document has been reduced according to the feature selection. So the advantage here being if you have hundreds of thousands of requirements, you can add a level of abstraction. You have maybe 200 features. You make your decisions, and based on that, the right requirements are picked for you. And at the same time, as we did this for the whole global configuration, also the right test cases belonging to it are picked for you. And the architecture, the MBSE on MBSE side is reduced accordingly and generated and placed into the variant specific global configuration. And from that point, as mentioned earlier, it doesn't even stop. So thanks to global configurations and version control in the background, we can now update an existing variant in an automated way. So let's say after we have manually changed it locally. So let's say we locally change this variant-specific global configuration. So inside, we make a change to a requirement, which we want to keep. At the same time, we want to receive new content from the product line engineering side, so from the 150%. For example, we are adding a new feature of Hoglite to the variant, and we want to receive all the requirements and architecture elements and test cases connected to that. So we trigger the transformation again, which gives us a new global configuration that branches out of a newer baseline of the 150%, maybe even now. And this holds then the assets representing the new version of the variant. But we also want to keep our local changes. For that, we can point at the earlier version of the variant, and we can tell here which of those local changes we want to take over, and then apply, go into a merge to see, to compare a merge view to see what actually will be taken over. So which local changes from the earlier version will be taken over in the newer one, and what has been added in an automated way by the transformation in between if we compare the old version to the new one. This way, we have full flexibility working on both levels in parallel on 150% and 100% level. So what do we learn from this? What can you take away with you? Global configurations are great for managing engineering data across tool borders. You can baseline across engineering assets. You can provide context for OSLC links with global configurations that then live in that context to link across different engineering assets. You can branch on global configuration level to tell that there's a sub-branch, maybe for a different version, maybe for a different variant of your product, wherein you can continue to work independently. Yeah? On the other hand, product line engineering is great for systematic reuse of engineering assets. So you can formalize and make your engineer's knowledge that is many times often only present in engineers' minds and not written down. You can make it persistent, you can formalize it, and you can then use it for automated reasoning over it to identify whether a variant is valid or not. And you can beat the complexity when we talk about what can I reuse, when we want to answer the question, what can I reuse of my existing engineering assets? As you have this more high-level feature model that is connected to all your engineering assets and can then, based on your feature selection, calculate which solution assets you need. It also allows you to maintain your engineering assets centralized in 150% repository and make changes there, which are then propagated to the variants that need them in an automated way again, as engineering assets for a variant can be generated. So I hope in the presentation it became clear how they get together. So from our perspective, global configurations and product line engineering are a perfect match. And the reason for that is it fits well together. Yeah? Baselining across engineering assets, then if you also use product line engineering, also include baselining across feature models and variant models to ensure consistency between your feature models and your 150% engineering assets that are connected to them that you want to use to generate output out of. Global configurations provide context for OSLC links across engineering assets, which can be used to also link in that context via OSLC linked to features between assets and features. You can establish such links and also between variant models and, for example, whole test plans that you generated for a variant. You can also establish such OSLC links. And then this linking information can also be used in analysis tools to create reports and see which features affect which part of your engineering assets and so what the choice to include or exclude a feature actually means for the different variants. The branching, so global configurations can be branched, and this can be used by the product line engineering tool. So this way it can generate whole GC branches for each variant instead of just generating one by one the variant specific output. So everything that you generate is nicely brought together and in a context again. So I hope this was helpful to just provide some use case from an area that's all about systematic reuse, where we see that global configurations are really valuable. I mean, not they are not valuable on their own, but this combination really gives some value that is more than the two single things on their own provide. And I'm happy now to answer questions if there are any. Thank you.